Hello and welcome to the Django Celery Mastery course. Just a quick reminder, if you like this course and would like to access the source code and more, you can access this course on Udemy. The link to the course, which should provide the best price, is in the video description. Let's just work through the basics of starting the new Celery worker. Now, as I mentioned previously in the Docker Compose file here, we mentioned that the Celery container or the Celery worker won't need to start the Django server, but it will require a separate command to start the Celery worker. This is how we're going to differentiate it from the Django project, in that we are going to use a command to start the Celery worker in this container. Of course, it's worth noting that there are multiple parameters and definitely worth looking through the documentation. But just to get things started and to get the Celery worker active in the container, let's first of all use the, remember this is a command prompt command. So we are going to activate Celery. So we start with Celery, and then we're going to need to specify the Celery application. In this case, app equals, and that's called dcelery. And then next up, we're going to start a worker. So we just need to use the word worker there. And then we can use, or we can then specify the level of information that we want to retrieve. So here then, this option sets the login level to info. So this is the log level, which means the type of data or the amount of data that's going to be shown in the logs. Now, while we're developing, we can set that to info. Now, info just happens to be the default log level, which there are many of. It's not necessarily important at this point for us to understand or to introduce all of them, but generally five different log levels: debug, info. I mentioned this is generally the default, warnings, error, and critical. So critical tends to be the highest log level. That's reserved for critical errors or failures that severely impact the application's operation. So here we're just going to set this to info, and that's going to provide us some information in the log in the terminal. Just before we restart Celery, I've noticed, just looking through the code base here, we've made a small mistake. So app conf, actually this should be app config. So it should be app config underscore from underscore object. Okay, so that's what we're looking for, that method there. So I think that was the only mistake we've got. So let's go ahead and compose build again. Let's go back into Docker desktop here, and it looks like it's running. So if we now go into, what I've done is I've selected the name Celery with my mouse. You can't see my mouse cursor, but I've selected Celery. That takes me into the terminal, into the logs here, and I can now see what's happening behind the scenes. Now, if you're seeing this, it looks like Celery has been activated or started successfully. So if we quickly just read through what we see here, this is a good start for debugging if you do have any problems. You can see that we have identified, or Celery has identified successfully, the Redis message broker, where to actually send messages, and then potential, or to retrieve them. And then potentially we now know where the results backend is. Okay, so that's configured correctly. And you can see down here we have two tasks. So we've now registered, we've now created and registered two new Celery tasks. So if your tasks aren't appearing here, there's an issue with registering your tasks. So Celery can't find your tasks. Now, if we read through the rest of this setup, there are a few different issues because we haven't set up many of the other settings that we could configure. We're told about a security warning, and here we have a warning related to Celery 6 and some of the depreciation of maybe some of the different settings. So that isn't necessarily related to any setup issues, just a warning about some potential updates in the next versions of Celery. If we look at the bottom here, we're told that Celery is ready.